Montana's Democratic U.S. Senator John Tester has made working with President Trump a big part of his reelection campaign so far. But on two significant bipartisan bills this spring, the president has not necessarily returned the favor. MTN's Mike Dennison has the story.
Senator Tester has been a key Democratic player on two big bills this year, the VA Mission Act to reform the veterans' health care system and the bill easing federal regulations for smaller banks. He and his Senate Veterans Committee staff co-wrote the VA bill with GOP Chairman Johnny Isaacson, and Tester was only one of 16 Senate Democrats supporting the banking bill. Yet Tester wasn't invited to the signing ceremony with the president on either bill. Instead, Trump invited Montana's Republican U.S. Senator Steve Daines, who did support both measures.
The Mission Act is an important step forward, and I'm proud to have helped get this bill across the finish line and on to President Trump's desk.
The VA bill passed the Senate 92-5 and was signed by the president last week. The Mission Act seeks to bolster the troubled VA health system, including steps to enable private care when care at a VA facility isn't available. Matt Kuntz of the Montana Office of the National Alliance on Mental Illness says an important change is raising the reimbursement rate for private doctors when they treat vets in smaller towns.
The big deal is, can the veteran get care at the end of the day? And without a reasonable provider reimbursement rate, the answer is no.
He also says Senator Tester is clearly a central figure on veterans' health issues.
And that means that whenever something goes wrong, he's going to get blamed. But whenever there's a veteran that gets care and that gets the help that they need, he's behind the scenes making it happen.
Tester himself says the work isn't over and that Congress must ensure the VA carries through with the changes put into law.
We did our job by crafting this legislation, and now the VA must do its job and effectively roll it out.
As far as who gets the credit, Tester's office says he's a workhorse, not a show horse. But with the general election campaign now underway, you can be sure that claim will be put under the microscope many times over. At Fort Harrison, Mike Dennison, MTN News.
In the election, Tester is facing Republican Matt Rosendale, Libertarian Rick Breckenridge, and Green Party candidate Steve Kelly.